To take Nathan as my husband.
And Nathan, what is your intent?
To take Isabella as my wife.
Okay, so Isabella and Nathan have requested this reading. All right, and
you missed the kids there, so I keep.
Okay, if I speak in tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. Does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. For where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see the face to face. Now I know in part. Then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of this is love. Okay? So, before we do the vows, We're going to need the rings of the best man and the Nirvana. Okay. Marriage is one of the greatest human relationships you will ever experience. But in order for marriage to reach its full potential, you must allow God to play a primary role in your relationship. He will be the glue that binds when things are good, but especially when life brings us sorrow and heartache. Okay, so you're facing each other. You can get a little closer.
Get too close.
Let me see the rings.
Yes.
All right. Now, Nathan, as you slide the ring onto Isabel's finger, you're to repeat after me.
Okay.
I, Nathan Reed. Take Isabella to be my wife. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or worse. For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and cherish. Until death do us part. As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
Now, Isabella. As you really slide the ring on this finger.
Which your left hand.
This way. Okay.
Get this one.
Got it.
Okay. I, Isabella Santana.
Take Nathan Reed.
To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and health. To love and cherish.
Until death do us part.
As God is my witness. I give you my promise. Nathan, not yet. Nathan, do you take Isabella as your wife?
Yeah, I do.
Isabella, do you take Nathan as your husband?
I do.
Okay. I have one last prayer. Dear Lord, we come today as family and friends to ask your blessing upon Nathan and Isabella. In the power vested to me by the Universal Life Church and by the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now.
Oh my god.
My name is Justin. I'm Nathan's best man, for those of you who don't know me. Nathan and I have been friends since the beginning of middle school. I remember when I first met him, I was like, damn, that's like a brother that I never met. He looked a little like me. But the funny thing is, for years, people just mistake us as brothers, which is really weird. But we always were into the same things and had the same sense of humor in a way. There's not many people I put my utmost trust in, and especially in times where your life is at risk. I remember many times being in West Virginia, riding the razors through the mountains with Nathan at the wheel. For those of you who know Nathan is, you know how that goes.
Yes.
It's like you got a NASCAR driver at the wheel, well, at least in his mind. One time he tried to, you know, show off how good he was, and he was driving, and he was going to drift around the corner, and, you know, normal people just go slow, take it around the corner, but he floors it, sends it, and he drifted right in the guardrail, and right on the other side of the guardrail, it was just straight down the mountain. I was like, this is on front of it, okay. And then another time, Nathan being Nathan again, we were flying down a new pick that he just found, and he's only been down it once last time he was down in West Virginia. So we're flying down this path, and you know, Nathan being Nathan, he knows all the roads, and we come around the corner, he thinks it's a wide bend. Nope, it's a sharp left. He slams on the brakes and turns, and we just barely make it around without sliding off the mountain. Like I said, I was scared as shit at that moment, but I had no doubt and the utmost trust that Nathan would handle the situation, any other situation, whenever he was at the wheel. So I can literally say, trust him. I see how you and Izzy act together and how your personalities play off each other so well. Izzy, you playing off Nathan's sarcasm and, you know, him being like Google every single time. Although we aren't real brothers, I can say you'll always be like a brother to me, and I wish you guys the most successful and joyful marriage possible. Izzy, he's your prom now.
All right, at this time, I'd like to ask Gabriella Reed to please come to the microphone.
Sister-in-law, for anyone who doesn't know who I am, I just wanted to start off by saying what a beautiful day today is for Nathan and Isabella. Two people coming together to become one. I remember when this was first booked, and Izzy's countdown was like 713 days, and now the wait is finally over. I just could not be happier for them and excited to see where life takes them. Nate, I just wanted to say what a great brother-in-law you've been to me. I will never forget when I married your brother and you right away called me your sister. That was a really nice memory and stuck with me forever. I wanted to say thank you for also giving me my best friend. Izzy, from the first time I met you, we instantly clicked. You came all the way to Connecticut without me to help us move back to New Jersey. You're always there for me. I have always said you were the friend I was waiting my whole life for. There is no one I would rather stand in my kitchen talking for hours with, and yes, literally standing. You guys were made for each other, so fun, always laughing at each other's jokes. It is really nice to see. I wish you both nothing but so much love and happiness in your marriage, and I wanted to share a little quote. When you realize you want to spend the rest of your life with somebody, you want the rest of your life to start as soon as possible. Congratulations, I hope you guys, to the new Mr. and Mrs. Reed.
And at this time, Gianna Santana.
Cry with mine. It's gonna be not sentimental as hell at all. Oh my god, no, I'm nervous. Those were so nice. Okay, so I'm Izzy's little sister. If you didn't know that, you're probably Nate's family, so it's okay. But if you're my family, you didn't know that, you really should not be here. anyways, I am also known as the best Santana to exist, so if anyone is wondering. So just to preface this, we need to talk about our dynamic. Izzy cries all the time, I laugh all the time, so she's really sentimental. I'm not. So this is my attempt at being sentimental. It's not gonna be a good one. So to try and get sentimental, I was like, what's sentimental? Like a poem. So I'm gonna read you guys a little poem. Guys, you're already laughing at me. You're making my head so big. Anyways, here's the poem. Roses are red, violets are blue. You have a sister? Well, not the one I do. To get things started and keep it lighthearted, I guess we should go back to where it all started. She's been very protective of her little sister, but has always kept me safe as a personal babysitter. She may be opinionated and she may be loud, but she never fell short of bossing me around. But through the screams when our voices would break, we also laughed so hard that our ribs would ache. She's loud and annoying and cries way too much, but she's also a badass who has always known what she wants. Okay, end poem. Thank you. So I didn't realize we were doing like fun short speeches. Mine's kind of long, so I'm really sorry, guys. I'm sorry, I just lived with her my whole life. I got a lot to say. So my sister has always wanted to be a mother. I feel like that's very known from anyone who has known her. You know, she loves all the babies, every baby since she was born, every last one, except for yours truly. She did, in fact, sit on my head when my parents brought me home. Yeah, you would think, like, you know, she got better, you know, we got closer, laughed a lot. Yeah, no. I've never seen someone be so protective of a person and yet so ungodly ruthless at the same time. But you know what? I do know one thing, that her future kids, whoever messes with them, good luck. Whoa, I would be so unbelievably scared if I was them. She is gonna be a force to be reckoned with those kids. But you know, I can't wait to be an aunt to these kids because, you know, they're gonna be really cute. And you know, I know that because as I always say, two negatives make a positive. I did get permission. I just want to say I got permission from both of them to say that because some people got really scared when I said that. But before I continue talking about me and my sister's craziness, you know, I do have to talk about the man that brought us all here today, Nate. Izzy saying your name is forever engraved in my mind. I just heard Nathan. I wish you would leave. It's not gonna anytime soon. So, you know, Nate, you know, you're kind of chill, so thanks for that. Okay, Izzy, I just wanted to say, I'm kidding. Okay. So, it's hard for me to be really nice to Nate because our entire relationship consists of us yelling at each other and roasting each other. So, it's really hard. So, you know, I was like, I went up to him and I was like, what should I say about you? You know, something nice. He's like, I don't care. I was like, you're really helpful. So, you know, this is what I came up with. So, everyone. So, like, I read it to some people and they were like, I was like, you never shared a bathroom with him, so you have no say in what I say about him. Let's talk about the first time I saw you two together. I remember this day fondly. I was talking to my mom in her room. It was the morning time, and we saw Nate's car pull up from the window. Yes, they had a little sleepover. Dad, you can't get mad. They are now married. they are now married, so can't get mad. You're welcome. Kept that for you. So we saw the car pull up, and I was like, oh my God. Nate's dropping Izzy off. And me and my mom, like any normal, civilized human beings, darted to the window. Of course, we ran to the window to look at what was gonna happen. So my mom was like, I need to see what this kid looks like. And I was like, I'm nosy. So we ran, and I was like, okay, okay. And then my mom was like, okay, she's taking too long, and went and sat back in her bed. And then all of a sudden, I see they give a sweet little kiss goodbye. Oh, so sweet, right? Yeah, a normal person would think that. I audibly said, did she kiss him without brushing her teeth? That was my concern. I think she did. I asked her when she walked in. She's like, yeah, what's wrong with you? But yeah, I lost my spot, guys. I'm sorry. Oh, yes, that's actually, there was a reason to that story, and it was because that's how I knew you guys were going to fall in love with each other. Because only people who fall in love can do that. That's crossing the line. Nate, you really, truly make Izzy happy, and as her sister, that's all I've ever wanted for her. You two make a great couple, and you truly love her, which is what she will always deserve. It's strange that you, my sister, are literally married. It's frankly disgusting. But we will always be the Santana sisters, even if you're ditching our last name, you know, whatever. But I love you so much. I know I'm a pain in the ass all the time, but I will forever be grateful that I got you as my big sister. You are a soul like no other and a force to be reckoned with. Today, all of your dreams are coming true, and I'm so excited to witness it all. Here's to the rest of your life. Oh my God, are you crying? Yay! Thank you!
Single ladies. Isabella, is that it? Is that all the girls? All right, girls. Isabella, don't do anything without me. On the count. Oh, no, 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 no. We got more girls coming. All the single ladies. All right, on the count of three. Wait, we have one to the farthest left. We have one in the back. You should go on the golf course. On the count of three, one, two, three. All right, Isabella, don't go far. If somebody can get Isabella a chair on the dance floor. All right, guys, we need a chair for Isabella. Thank you. Nathan, are you ready, buddy? This is where stars are made, pal. Isabella, take a seat. Nathan, we need you. Here we go. My man. Ha. All the single guys. All the single guys. Come on, guys. Yeah. There's got to be more guys. Where's the single guys? Nah. Nathan. Is this it? Are you saying? Yeah, mommy. There's got to be more single guys. That's a good point. You're still single, God forbid, if you are engaged. So we need all the single guys. Hey, we got one. He's definitely not catching it. That's it. My man, get in there, buddy. I hear you. Guys, box out. Do something. All right, Nathan, are you ready? Yeah. Put your back to them. Wait for me. Wait for the count of three. Gentlemen. Guys, are we ready? How are you catching it with the drink in your hand? Are you good like that? All right, I got you. On the count of three. One, two, three. The fix was in. And the young lady that caught the bouquet.